What's going on, guys? Today is May 22nd. This is HorsePLAY Live Uncut, episode 23. Stop it, Google. Stop it. And we'll make sense of that. Anyway, Obi and I are getting the tweets out to let people know that we're about to get started as we pre-show here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Word.
Word. You know what I'm saying?
This is weird. I don't know why I can't. Oh, there we go. Nice. I see it. I'm about to say, why can't I see your freaking tweet?
Oh, sorry.
I'm sorry, man.
It looks like we both had a busy week.
Yeah, mine's a little bit more, I don't want to say more important, but it's been hell.
Oh yeah, I've had my fair share of that too.
It's been hell, I tell you.
Anytime you have a significant other, that's inevitable. I'm not saying yours involves that, but you know.
All right. Well, listen to the voicemail I sent you the other earlier today or yesterday. So.
If it was today, I'm all sorry, right. Mr. Carl. I've been like freaking.
It's all good. Just keep it quiet. I don't want to say anything right now because you're recording. this is uncut, so.
I know. We'll do it for the offline. Cause I'm pretty wired right now anyway.
Definitely. So how you been this week, man?
Well, you tell me to be quiet, and then you ask me how you.
Oh, shit, my bad. We'll ask you in the show. I'm going to get ready to start here, and I'm going to put the music up. We still
got 2 minutes. I thought it was already 11.
Well, yeah, it's 10:59, so.
Ooh. There we go.
All right, start an intro screen. Welcome back, everybody. This is Horse. I hear it for some reason still. I don't know. This is HorsePLAY. Welcome back, geeks and gamers, to HorsePLAY Live. Today is May 22nd, 2014. I know why. It's because I have my other one on, my stream on. Yeah. 2014, episode 23. Titled Stop It, Google. Just stop it. I'm joined, as always, by that crazy Puerto Rican mofo, Yogi Zilla. What's up, man?
Yeah, yeah. Yo, what's good, yo?
What's good, yo? Yeah, that was like a really shitty start because I didn't turn my stream off, so I heard it like double. So I was like, wait a minute, what's going on? I was hearing like, yeah.
We are masters of shitty starts. It's our thing.
Hey, it's either a really shitty start or a start that nothing goes wrong. Well, guess what? We never had a start that just didn't go wrong. And I didn't flip it, of course. Right now, I'm on the right one. And I didn't even flip the freaking the broadcast. So they're still looking at the intro screen. Welcome, everybody. This is HorsePLAY once again, right here, OB1X2. My partner in crime right over there, Yogizilla. Man, this has been a hell of a week. I'm going to say.
No kidding.
it just all for the beginning, it's just the amount of things that we've done myself and my wife this week for the house and for, you know, just real life stuff is just holy crap. I need to slow down for a second. But no, we're just getting so much stuff done. I'm just so tired, though. I'm starting a new schedule, too, which this show does not help that schedule whatsoever. So it's kind of to the point where I'm like, do I want to do it? Yes, I have to. Because if I don't, I've been kind of told in a way that's not being told that if you don't change your schedule, you're going to have problems with me. So you can understand that, yo. You're married. You know how it is. Mama says do something. You say,
yep.
How well? You know, how much do you want me to do it? All of it? Yes, ma'am. You know, don't argue with it. Just go with it. Of course, we have quite a few friends in chat, as always. Not Panda. Welcome. T. Kurt. What's happening, big man?
Oh, when they used to be everybody, in here. Oh, there we go.
Horseplay Live rocks out every Thursday at 11 p.m. Eastern time on Twitch channels Obi-Wan X2 and Yogizilla. So you guys can check those. If you guys do want a dual stream, you guys can hit multistream.com and put in just Yogizilla and Obi-Wan X2, and you can watch both of them at the same time. Yogizilla has the uncut version, which he puts up on his channel on YouTube at Yogizilla on YouTube. And of course, just, you know, of course, right here at I mixed up. Oh, yeah. We also hang out on allgames.com chat, just live. Check live and you guys can join the fun, or you can join us right here on the live stream. I'm saying live so many times. But if you guys don't get the chance to hear the Thursday night show, allgames.com, Thursdays at 5 p.m. Eastern time. We're currently opening for the B-Team podcast, which is kind of ironic because we open for them and then they open for us.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So
still right before, it still blows my mind.
It does. But here pretty soon, I believe we have some, I don't know if it's a definite, it is definite that he's coming. There's a new show going to be starting at 7 p.m. on All Games. And that's actually the owner of allgames.com, which is going to be up. So I'm excited for that just to see what he's got coming on. So, but we can, Horseplay is on. Like I said, if you guys can't get the show, you guys can listen to us Thursday night at 5 p.m. Eastern time on allgames.com. Currently, we're opening for, like I said, for B-Team. They start at 7. So we just want you guys to just come on, and more than likely, 9 times out of 10, myself and Yogi are there all day long.
You start at 9.
Today, I wasn't. What? Yes. No, they start at 9, and then the new show is going to be at 7.
Yeah, so right now we're...
I think I got that right.
Right now, it's us at 5 p.m. at allgames.com, mm-hmm. and then there's a gap. So, yeah.
Don't forget to tweet us throughout the show, guys, and just throughout the week. I mean, we love to get tweets from you guys and hear responses from the, you know, future shows or even past shows that we've done. Just, you know, you guys can tweet us right here, Obi-Wan X2, at Yogizilla, and at Geeky Antics. Don't forget them, guys. And of course, right here, you can join the main hub, the live channel right here at Obi-Wan X2, and of course, Yogizilla's. Yogi, since I'm not reading well today, I'm just going to start like this. How are you doing, man?
Great, man. Like, I'm in the same place you're at. I've been, you know, it's not just a first world problem. It's just a lot of work going on in the home front and a lot of juggling. And trust me, I know exactly where you're at, because it's like I tell my better half, I'm like, look, honey, I need to stick to a regimen. I need to get to schedule. And sometimes she makes, like, these simple little things into high-priority things. I'm like, can this wait? I think it could wait. And she, everything has to be done right then and there and needs to be given 100% attention. I can't multitask. Lord forbid I multitask. I'm like, well, I'm trying to wrap up this blog post, or I'm trying to help this new person that's joining our site be able to get started with their stuff and blah, blah, blah. She don't want to hear it.
But, you know, you got three more people coming to gang. They love you, Yogi.
Oh,
that's what they told me. They said we don't want to join for you, Obi. We love Yogi. We want that Puerto Rican.
Yeah, sure. I appreciate that, but I know you're full of it.
Last but not least, you can join us on our official HQ at geekyantics.net. Now I'm going to read that, but I'm going to say .com as well because it takes you to the same exact spot. You guys comment, share, and just party with us. Our team is working very hard to bring you guys some just awesome content. Yogi, you got anything going on? I mean, we got some newer gang members. I know we shouted out Doc last week. We guys want to make sure you guys check out the DocRoe Chronicles.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, so we're going to have a formal shout-out period segment. Period. I'm thinking sports terminology now. I don't know. My brain's all over the place. But, yeah, we do want to acknowledge our latest contributors, DocRoe. Obviously, he's got his series, the DocRoe Chronicles, and he's got the show that he's going to be doing with you on Sunday slot, which is great because Sunday's like a barren wasteland for geek culture and the gaming community as a whole, which is kind of weird. He's taking out the clipboard. So it's going to be good. We're actually starting to fill out the whole week at Geeky Antics. And we're also collaborating with All Games to help them do some filling in gaps as well. So it's a great partnership there, informal as it may be. But we got DocRoe. We got another guy coming on board, he's an awesome dude. And he's an old fart like us. He's also ex-military as well. And his name is Coach Newman. And he's been in here before, and I'm excited about that because he brings a more mature perspective into gaming, and he's going to be covering, he's going to do some, that's what we need, a little diversity. So he's going to do more retro-style gaming. He's really big on the 32-bit era, so that's awesome. He's really big on the indie stuff, but he's also doing some current stuff. He's going to do some reviews. There's a lot of things that we have gaps for that he's going to be covering. Look at Fraxion in the chat. There's not the pie. Yes, the pie is coming. Oh yeah, but before I forget, over at geekyantics.net we got a lot of stuff going on. I want to plug again the Geeky Antics Twitch channel, which we've just pimped out. It looks beautiful now. It's coming together. Mm-hmm. And we're gonna, now that we got all these contributors joining us, including established streamers on Twitch and new people that are coming on there, and people mm-hmm. from YouTube, people that do podcasts. Well, we got a whole bunch of stuff coming over there. We're trying to do a lot of exclusive content, and we're going to do a lot of sharing of existing content. So that stuff's going to start coming up. So come over there, and you can see all the information about our current schedule, and we're going to keep updating that. And on geekyantics.net, our main hub, we got an article about, we had to talk about it, the late breaking news. Not by the time people listen to this, it won't be, but you know. About the whole Google and Twitch thing, which we're gonna get to. We're gonna get to that. I didn't want to spill the beans, but I just want to say there is a poll over there that people get involved with, mm-hmm. and we'll plug that again later.
Definitely, you guys can make sure that you guys, if you guys want to voicemail or fax too, it's both devices for the same number, 206-415-4987. You guys are watching the live stream here. It's right above Yogi's head over there. You guys can throw us a voicemail. If we will play and respond to your messages live. Now, if you're shy, you can leave us an email you can leave us an email at mail@geekyantics.net. I said that right. Make sure you put mail@geekyantics.net. You can email us, and we'll respond during the prospective shows of your choice, if whatever topic you're talking on. So we are going to get right into our first segment. We got obligatory news. I don't know how you're going to say it, Yogi, but Yogi's going to take that away. And I do have some news to tack on the end of this.
Okay.
It's for Geeky Antics, and you're going to enjoy it. So the news.
Yeah, we got not as bad as it has been the past week. I'm trying to keep it trim because we're getting so many good conversations in the chat. But so let's see. Guess what we're gonna talk about? Can anybody guess? That's right. You gonna guess?
Can I guess?
You guess.
Hot dogs.
Close. It starts with the same letter.
Horny horses.
And it's the same amount of syllables. Then that one's a little off. I'll give you one more guess.
I don't want to guess it though. It's a thing.
What's it, Chief?
Yep, I seen it right there. It's in chat. Hearthstone.
Who said it in the chat? Who called it?
Nobody.
Nobody called it. Nobody. Nobody wanted to play.
Nobody even guessed what we were gonna talk about today. That hurts. It really hurts.
They're talking about other stuff in there. Right. But, yeah, we're gonna talk about the Hearthstone. It hurts. It hurts me. It hurts me right here.
My little 3-year-old kid goes, "Daddy, you hurt my heart." I'm like, "Aw, get over it."
Oh, God, he's already learning to milk it. Be careful.
Not for me, he ain't.
Yeah, I know. I'm saying, I'm a tough loved one, too, but...
Grandma, grandpas, my camera's going crazy right now.
Dude, speaking of that, I don't know what's going on with Skype, but a lot of people are having issues with it. I have to restart it before I do any podcasting or exit out of it during streams, because it's leaking memory bad, and tons of people are saying the same thing, regardless of what version of Windows they're on. So with Skype, you better get your stuff together.
Please. Anyway,
so there was a really interesting article. Well, actually, not so much an article. I don't know if people are aware of the Metacritic scores. I was about to jump ahead. From Hearthstone, but it was hovering around 95, 93. Now it's at around 88 last I checked, but it's still rocking. Now, the reason I think this is important to mention is because this is a card game, a game that most people will not consider something they would enjoy. But pretty much anyone that gives Hearthstone a real try is loving it. Unless they get into the mindset of, oh, this is a pay-to-win game, or I'm not good enough for this kind of game. Mm-hmm. And I don't believe that. I think you need to just get with people that can break it down in simple terms and help you find out how you can have the most fun with it. And once Crystal Next Rammus comes up, things are going to really be awesome for everyone. But, you know, what's interesting, though, you look at the user reviews and you see tons of 10s. The critics all give 10s, pretty much, 10s and 9s. But then the user reviews is where you start to see 2s and 0s. And I'm like, that's a bit rough. No one should be giving this game a 2 or a 0 unless you just don't like to use your brain. That's the only thing I can think of. Or you're a graphic snob. Like, this doesn't have, like, really high polygon counts. Like, I don't get it. So, some people are just being brutal just for the sake of trolling. It's like, whoa. What happened? People in the chat.
People are always going to do that. And it's gonna, yeah.
But, I realize I'm looking really gruffy, really scruffy, rather. I didn't get to shave. But anyway, another thing that's interesting that I enjoyed, just going away for reviews, because you can't reviews, who really measures the quality of a game by reviews anymore? It's like Fred Rojas said before, on our show and on Gaming History 101, the traditional review, it's kind of being phased out. It doesn't have as much... People, because, you know, the gaming community already knows that they don't really trust the mainstream stuff. They look at it just for the previews, but the opinions and, you know, the scores, they kind of like, yeah, take it with a grain of salt. Watch Dogs is a good example. I think that game is going to disappoint a lot of people. That's all I'm saying. But anyway,
it already has.
Yeah, but, you know, that
already has disappointed a lot of people.
Well, that's the thing. They have an embargo, so people are not supposed to talk about it, but they still are. But anyway... Earlier this month, Kotaku posted an interview that I really loved, and it was about Hearthstone as well. And it really shows how Hearthstone started from humble beginnings. This is another reason why I love this game. It's not an indie game, but it's got that small team indie feel to it. Because originally, it was just two people working on the game, Eric Dodds and Hamilton Chu, if I got my facts straight. And now it's Team 5, and I think they have like 16 people, and they're expanding the team. They're posting up jobs that... They're doing a lot of big stuff, which we're gonna get into. There's a lot of Hearthstone news right now. But they released a wonderful game against all odds. In fact, Blizzard did not want to make a card game. They were like, card game? Let's make another MMO. Well, who's going to play a card game? But they went to the point to make this game happen. They started taking pen and paper and creating proofs of concept and little prototypes of the game until they could finally get the resources committed to make the mm-hmm. game happen. I think that's freaking awesome. Now, will we just ignore those links? Some of those links that I posted there do have nothing to do with what I just talked about there. That's going to be for the upcoming piece, just so you know. They also, another thing is really encouraging. They have a official Blizzard tournament that's going to happen at BlizzCon. Pretty much anyone can qualify for it, mainly through doing ranked play. That's going to be part of it. It's going to be by region. It's gonna be pretty selective, but the grand prize is gonna be 100K. That's kind of a big deal. 100K for the number one player.
Damn.
Yeah, bro. We're in the wrong line of work. But
we're in the long wrong line of something. Shit, if they're getting that much.
I'm just loving what's going on in the chat. I'm going to speak to it soon enough after we go through the news. Maybe we'll pull some people in. But some late-breaking news. And this is pretty late breaking because I literally found out about this as this was kind of happening because I was tuning into a stream. But one of the few people that I watch on Twitch has actually got a ton of viewers. I usually stay away from the big viewership channels because they don't engage you and they're kind of boring, to be honest. And it's always like the smaller streamers that acknowledge you and they chat and it's fun. Mm-hmm. It's an experience. You know, you get the big ones, even on Hearthstone, they're just sitting there clicking. Like, Crip, I don't know how he gets, like, 10, 15K viewers at a time. Because he just sits there and just, like, farts and picks his belly button. But he's good at the game, but I don't know. But anyway, Team Solo Mid has recruited Harry Masan Chung. I believe I'm pronouncing his last name right.
Yeah.
For their Hearthstone team. He's the only person on their team. But Gosu Gamers, they reported that with the quickness, like 3 or 4 hours after it happened, they already had an article up. So you check that out there. It was cool. He was actually talking about some of the details of it, but you know, due to the contract, he can't get too in detail. And people were like, how much money they're paying you, blah, blah, blah. Because you know, he's not sponsored by them. He's a member of their team. So like basically he's salaried. People are trying to get all personal. It's like, come on, don't do that. No one likes to talk about how much money they make, whether it's a lot or a little. That's kind of, I don't know.
Right.
It's like touching a no-no place. But, you know, it's interesting. At this point in the game, Hearthstone just went public, you know, officially a couple months ago, really. And it's already getting some serious esports treatment. It's growing rapidly. I'm telling you, this is going to be one of the biggest games online and definitely mm-hmm. Blizzard's flagship game as far as I'm concerned. And, you know, whether you're interested in competitive Hearthstone or not, I think it's exciting news for all the Hearthstone players and Blizzard fans. So, I mean, it's good stuff, man. You excited about this, man?
I am, dude. I cannot wait. The only thing that I don't like about it is it's just going into another... I mean, are they going to... How are they going to get... I mean, are they just going to keep searching around for players that want to be on their team? I mean, I'm just not understanding.
Well, what do you mean? Why you don't like the fact that Team Solo Mid is going into Hearthstone? Or
no, I'm not saying that at all. I'm just it's to the point where are they? I don't know what I'm trying to say. I think it'll be fun. I think it'll be good, especially to break up the monotony of a little bit of the esports, the law, because that's what esports is. It's League of Legends. I mean, really think about it. I mean, yeah, they have more games. They do have Hearthstone professional players. They do have stuff, even though Hearthstone just started. It's a big starter game, but they already got professional players? Come on, man.
Backpedal a little bit. If you really want to be fair, I would say esports really got big on the PC front with StarCraft 2. That's when it really started getting hardcore. But Blizzard is already putting more into this than they ever have with anything else. Now, and also on the console, you can say Call of Duty is kind of a big deal too worldwide. You know, love it or hate it. But yeah, I mean, you know, League of Legends is probably the biggest esports event right now. There's no, I mean, it's the most played game online, so there's no doubt about it. But we gotta be fair to StarCraft 2. that's actually where Masan got his start. And what I love about it is that he's a really down-to-earth dude. Like, his chat moves super fast. And he's acknowledging people in there, answering questions, and still playing well in the game, which I tip my hat to him because I get tunnel vision. If I want to play well and not totally scrub it up, I can't really focus on the chat that much. And I'd rather spend time with the people in the chat than be good at the game because I'm not trying to be top tier. But you know, I'm really happy for him. He's a good guy. And he's just a really, really cool, chill dude. And he's definitely more exciting to watch than Trump SC. Trump SC is cool, but gosh, he's kind of a doorknob when it comes to personality. I'm sorry.
Some people have the like you said, it was a couple weeks ago when we were talking about this, the you know, starting streaming. Some people have that to where they can engage with the chat and still play the game, not miss a beat. Some people, not so much. They can only do one thing at once because they can't concentrate on the screen, or they only have one screen, or just whatever. There's just some people are made for streaming, some people are not.
Yeah, or there's the ones, a lot of them are the big ones that already have such a viewership, they don't even bother with the little things because they don't have to. You know, they got that YouTube mentality. It's like, create the content and, you know, let it do the work for you. And that's fine, mm-hmm. but that's not what I look for. But anyway, now this is perfect segue. You opened it up for us here, Obi. So, our worst fears have been confirmed. Dramatic pause.
Dum, dum, dum.
Google is rumored to be acquiring Twitch. Now we knew this. We knew this had to happen, Obi. We've been talking about this possibility for a while, and some of the things they've been doing with the partners program, and how it's becoming a lot more selective, and yet it's not. Because they do, you know, to become a Twitch partner, they'll make exceptions if they see you already have good social media background or already have a following.
I have something for this. Well, no. I have, because I watched somebody that he only averaged like 50 viewers.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And what Twitch did is instead of getting because you had to actually have like 350 viewers for 6 weeks straight. Every time you streamed, you had to stream more than five times a week or four times a week. You had to have this many viewers on, and then you could possibly get chosen for a Twitch, you know, basically a sub button. Okay, a partnership. Now Twitch has basically just lowered all their standards to where if you have 50 plus, and I'm going to say his name, Elemental QT, props to him, shout out, blah, blah, blah. But he only runs 50 plus people minimum, or, you know, sometimes it's like 20. He got a sub button just because he streams every single day. He streams the content that people want to watch.
Yeah.
So basically, yes, if you petition for somebody to get a sub button, yes, but you need a lot of fucking signatures for it. You know, if you're going to go in, yes, would myself, once we get Geeky Antics all started up, would we love a sub button? You're damn right. Are we going to not do our best because we don't have one? No. Are we not going to try to play the games and put out the content that we put out every single week because we don't have one? No. Yeah. It's just an added bonus. It's something to say, hey, guys. And a sub button is saying, you know, from you guys saying, you know, hey, we want to support you. Thank you very much. We're sending a sub to you every month.
Yep.
Thanks. You know, that's just something that we do this because we love to do it. We're not out to make millions of dollars. It's not going to happen.
Yeah. And here's the thing. What the, you know, and we're going to talk about how we're going to get into a whole segment about this. So, because right now we're just going to stick to the news portion of it. Mm-hmm. But you know what? Let's hold off on that because we're going to have a segment for that. But I love what you're saying there because this news is going to impact, if, you know, once this deal goes through, it's not if it will go through, it's when. Once they finalize everything, it's going to be a transition phase. The problem is that if YouTube absorbs all of Twitch into their ecosystem, it's going to ruin what Twitch is and what makes it special. And Google's going to shoot themselves in the feet. They should have the YouTube resources thrown into Twitch, but keep Twitch as its own entity. And we'll talk about that. Excuse me. That was terrible. But, you know, the nice thing about it is that Twitch is growing really fast, and having mm-hmm. Google's resources would help them, you know, meet the demand. And, you know, finally get some updates. But, you know, you look at what happened with Dodgeball and other acquisitions that Google has had. They just throw money around. They're on a $30 billion spending spree. And a lot of the stuff they're buying, a lot of the things they start up, Google Labs, you know, Feedburner, they just kind of let it sit there. Mm-hmm. Google Labs, they finally shut down. And Google Labs was great. People were dependent on that because it has so many useful tools in it. Dodgeball, which is now Foursquare, but it's owned by a different company. Dodgeball, they let it die. Foursquare could have been Google's, but they just bought it because it was a competitor, and they just let it die.
They basically shut it down. If they were not gonna, you know, if we're not gonna use it, we already have something like this, so we're not gonna sit there and have two times, you know, possible. Then what if happens if somebody says, hey, you know, I'm gonna take this idea and just tweak a little bit enough to where I'm not getting copyright infringement, and I'm just gonna start my own company. Well, guess what? Google left that open. Of course, it's just like any big business that takes over a small one. They're shutting it down. They're not. Why have it open? We already have the amount of money that's coming in. Now we don't need this.
Tim Curtis is asking, are we talking about Hearthstone yet? We're always talking about Hearthstone. And we would have a question. Do you believe that Google can benefit Twitch streamers? We're going to get to that, and we're going to involve you guys in that. So hold off on those questions, because I know this is going to be something that impacts us all, whether you just watch Twitch channels or you're a streamer or you're both. Like Obi and I, we support our fellow streamers, and we also stream as well. And it's tough to do because a lot of streamers feel like they shouldn't support other channels because it's taking away from their pockets. No, that's more reason to support other people because you know the struggles that they have to go through. But anyway, we're going to get into the details, and I said 100% in stone, but a $1 billion deal, it's going to happen. It's inevitable. We knew it was going to happen. The writing was on the wall. I mean, it's no coincidence that the YouTube export feature that wasn't working for a long time, like it would work here and there on Twitch, now suddenly it works every time.
Yeah, with no flaws.
With no flaws. Errors. You know, this has been in the making for a while. They've been having little lunch meetings and dinner meetings and all kinds of stuff. But anyway, we'll get back to that. So anyway, for the League of Legends players out there, Chris Voice is finally out of beta. I kind of missed this, and I feel bad because I did have a bunch of beta keys for our listeners.
I just got sent 3 yesterday.
Well, they're absolutely useless now. I was going to do some giveaways, and I was going to give you something to do on your channel, and then do some on the blog, and yeah. Mm-hmm. So, oh, well,
it's but all it's good. It's everybody cool, get it. It's actually good. It's a little good program.
Yeah.
It's just so we don't have to, you know, you guys are here in the beginning of the show. I, OB1X2, challenged my cohort here to a League of Legends 5v5 horseplay team Obi. I already have the team made against horseplay team Yogi. And he accepted. So the best way to get that is to get that cursed voice so we can actually communicate and we can stomp his ass.
Challenge accepted.
Please. Oh, yeah, I know. The last part of news, Yogi, I want to put out there, and it's just real quick. I'll make it fast.
Yeah.
You guys heard about myself or DocRoe at DocRoe Games and myself. We're going to start a new talk show. The talk show is going to be started Sunday, June 1st. And it's just a simple name. We couldn't really come up with any, and I couldn't come up with any to even put up a poll. So it's just the Doc and Obi show, guys, on Sunday morning at 9 p.m. Eastern time. I know it's early, but we are going to basically concentrate primarily on the EU scene. What's going on EU? What's going on? Because he does live in the Netherlands, and we do so much here on Horseplay. I don't want to double talk about stuff. I mean, it would be kind of good because we'd have something to talk about, but I don't want to do that just because it could take away or add. I just keep the show separate. But Sunday mornings, 9 a.m. Eastern time. I know it's a little early, so it will be recorded. I'm going to talk to Yogi about getting it on Stitcher and all that other stuff. So, and it's going to be on Geeky Antics, guys. So be looking forward to that. We got lots of new stuff going to come out, what we're going to talk about. It's going to be about the same kind of show, not same kind of show, but it's about the same time. So I hope you guys can join us for not this coming Sunday, but the following Sunday, June 1st, is the pilot episode of the Doc and Obi show. So I hope you guys can check that. What do we got going up, man? We got any updates?
Yeah, so last weekend I totally botched up. I said that the Steam free-to-play game was Renegade Ops. It wasn't. It was Chivalry Medieval Warfare. Not that it matters now, but I don't want to send misinformation out there. So my bad. Hey, at least I caught that after the fact.
Sorry, guys.
Sorry. It wasn't free. I just happened to own it already. I saw it and I was like, it's just, I don't know what it was. I saw it and it said play now. I don't remember buying it. And I guess it came as part of my Humble Bundle and it just popped into my library. And I was like, oh, a free-to-play game. I don't know how I made that connection.
Yeah,
oh my god.
Community events and giveaways, guys. Like I said, we're just going to keep going through this because we got a lot to talk about with our main feature. So
we could probably skip it if you want. We could probably skip ahead of this. I think we already talked about this. The League of Legends
deal
stuff.
So where am I at then?
Yeah. Community events and giveaways. All we're going to do is just recap what Obi said. We will be having League of Legends gaming nights. And it's going to be, we're going to do the ranked teams thing, the organized play. But, you know, I think the main thing we're going to do a lot of is ARAM and custom games just to have fun and have a chance to connect with our community. So, over at All Games and Geeky Antics, so.
If you're on my team, you better not lose. I'm going to be pissed.
Yes, casual is not in Obi's vocabulary. So, if you're really competitive, join his team. If you want a casual, join my team.
If you want to win, join my team.
Yeah. I do also want to invite everybody to, you know, make sure you leave us voicemails. That's always very nice. And, you know, the email, which we already talked about. But also, we have polls on geekyantics.net. If you look at the category community events and feedback, just in a little drop down or whatever, just go in there. You'll see lots of polls you could take. And the latest article on there at the moment, maybe by the time you listen to this, it may not be, is about the whole Twitch Google thing that we're going to get into. I'd like to see what people think about it, because some people think it's great, some people think it's bad. But we'll talk about that. All right, Obi, you can take the next section.
Man Crush and Geek Girls. Guys, this is where we basically, you know, I never do this segment, so I don't even know what it is, really. No, I'm just playing, guys. If you want to be a guest or suggest any favorite Man Crush or Geek Girls, contact us on Twitter, All Games, an official gang site, of course, right here at Obi1X2, YogiZilla, allgames.com, and, of course, geekyantics.net. I about said .com again, which doesn't matter. We'd love to hang out with you, and now let's share some of our Geeks of the Week. Yogi, you got some Geeks of the Week this week?
Well, you can go. You go first. I know you'd like to pick your streamer of the week.
I do. You guys do know that every week I go around just to. I don't hit big streamers up, and there's a reason why. I like to communicate with the streamer. I like to talk to them. When somebody, and I'm gonna just put it out there because he's a well-known streamer. When somebody like TSM, the Odd One streams, he's got 30,000 people in his stream, and he only sees like a literally a 20th of the chat because it goes so fast. Yes, he has it on slow mo, but he still goes so fast. Yeah. I like to hit the guys that up have like less than 500 people on it, and just hit them up. Mm-hmm. If it's a good stream, I like to shout them out on this show, just because. Hey, if I can't help gamers that are starting out, who else is going to?
Yep.
That's what Geeky Antics is for, guys, is we love to help out the little guys, just because. And, Yogi, you go ahead and shout yours out. I gotta find mine again. I lost it.
Well, this one's great because it's another Obi. You're Obi1X2, and this one is Obi Zyanka. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. I'm not good with Russian or Slavic languages in general, but Obi Zyanka is OBEZIANKA. If you like people that are energetic and crazy, but they're not forcing it, like I like Casey Tron, but I think sometimes she forces it. Like, she has a character that she plays every time. And I'll watch every now and then, but...
She's annoying as hell.
She does get annoying at times.
Stop it, guys! Stop it! I can't take this! Stop it!
She's like, seriously!
Stop it right now!
Seriously, guys! Seriously! I'm trying to concentrate. Let me think.
That people are gonna do that. You know, people, especially if you sit there and go, "Stop it, guys! I'm seriously freaking out." Right. You know, people are gonna keep doing it.
But it's all a show, dude. It's all a gimmick, and people eat it up. People eat that up because people like that. They like that toxicity, that trolling. That's her scene, and it works for her. I mean, I ain't hating, but that's her stick. But Obizyanka. You know, what I like about her is that she's really engaging. She acknowledges almost everybody that comes in there, and it gets crazy in there. But she still has a smaller audience, relatively speaking. Like, she's one of the biggest streamers. She does have the sponsor button and everything. You know, not sponsor button, the subscriber button. She's a formal Twitch partner. But, you know, it's still got this tightly knit community feel that I like, that warmth to it. Another one is one of our own, one of our gangsters over at Geeky Antics, Spaffyzilla. He's one of the few guys I've seen one of the first guys I've seen jumping on Landmark, which is a pretty interesting game. It's like a sandbox-style game, kind of along the vein of Minecraft, but with better graphics and a lot more things you could do in there. It's an interesting game. So check him out. He's just starting out with the Twitch thing, and, you know, we're a little partial to him because, you know, he's part of our family, and he's helped us out with so many things. But yeah, Obizyanka and Spaffyzilla, show them love. Send them. Let them know that Obi and Yogi over at HorsePLAY Live sent you, and they'll be very excited about that. The good peoples.
Of course, that's what we do, guys. We just, like I said, we're not here to just hurt any. Where's the freaking key I'm looking for? We're not here to hurt anybody or do anything like that or make anybody lose viewers or anything. No, we're here to help. We wanna get in and give these the little guys, and we're still little too, so it's not nothing that you know, we want to, but we want to give the, like I said, the little guys a chance to get their head out, get their word out, get their face out there to, and I know I'm talking and doing things at the same time, my bad, but get their face out there to actually, maybe just start their channel, be, do their dream, you know, that's what we're here for. The one that I, was checking out this week, and it's right here on the screen along with Obi Zinka, I love that name, and Spathzilla is short SHT9214, okay? Again, and I can't believe we did this, Yogi. We came up with two more girl gamers, okay? Because you got one and so did I. So, yes, there are girl gamers out there. We are finding them for you. I've invited her to gang. I invited her to gang just because it's a girl gamer, man, and she's not afraid to say, hey, I'm not a hoe. Shut your ass up. You know, you know, just she gets in with the chat, which is just awesome to me. So, guys, go check her out, too. It's twitch.tv/short, SHT9214. So, but that, we give a big shout-out to you on, it was a really good stream. It was really comical. And she plays basketball. She plays 2K14. Okay. I think it's on Xbox, or is that PlayStation?
I couldn't tell you.
It's both, actually. But she plays on, I believe it's Xbox is what she plays on. If I'm wrong, I am so sorry. PlayStation 4, I think it's Xbox One because she was talking about it. So, guys, go check out. Those are the shout-outs for this week's Man Crush Geek Girls segment. Yogi, do we want to do it?
What are we doing?
Geeks engage!
Yeah.
This is the segment where we want you guys to join the discussion. I know we have quite a few. Okay. Yogi, if you haven't been looking at Twitch chat lately, and you have because I see it, but we have quite a few people that have been going crazy asking questions like crazy. So what I'm going to give to you guys is... No, I'm not going to do that.
Hey, real quick shout out before we set that up. Mm-hmm. I'm Too Asian is in the chat. He was lurking. I see you, Too Asian. He's a League of Legends player too, so he's in the right place. Shout outs. And Obi Zyanka has been referring people to us, so you know, that's awesome, it's all man. About sharing love, you know. One of the things I want to say real quick, I know Obi feels the same way. Like, I hate this whole competitive attitude people have in business. And it goes into Twitch, it goes into YouTube. People feel like I need to hoard my audience and not share because then I might lose them. No, share the love because other people will return the favor, and you can't grow that fast or you can't grow consistently without some help. No one does it by themselves unless they're very lucky.
And no one has seen it happen, but yeah. It takes a very long time to grow by yourself. I can tell you right now.
You gotta get on because, the grind.
And two, and it for even for us guys, you guys see, even we're not like huge. Okay, I'm not gonna say that we're not freaking huge streamers. We're not freaking huge talk show hosts. We're not. We don't do that. We just started this, and it's 23 episodes ago, and the only reason we're as big as we are is because of allgames.com. Just because that's my dog. If it was one person, but it's not. It's a whole group of people that just help each other out, and that's what we're there. That's why we are there. And of course, that's why we start Geeky Antics, is because we want to help people out as much as possible. If you want to join the discussion,
word,
connect with us via the HorsePLAY Live. You guys can check that out. Just add us on Skype. Just search for HorsePLAY Live, HorsePLAY the space live. And you can, we'll get into discussion. And the gang voicemail hotline, 206-415-4987. If you do call and you do get in the call, please use headphones. I am sorry. And please mute the stream. Okay? If you don't have headphones on and I hear a bunch of stream in the background, I'm going to disconnect the call. Sorry. So please use headphones. Use the, mute the stream so we keep it all sane in here. Because if Yogi gets crazy, it's done. I mean, derail. It's actually this guy, but Anyway, all right, we're going to open up the lines. I am first. How many do you want, Yog? One or two? Three? Four?
Yeah, maybe we could get a roundtable discussion. I mean, we're trying to get two feature discussions, but I have a feeling we're just going to end up talking about this one topic. No, actually, we're making good time, so we'll see. But yeah, let's get like two or three people in. But in the meantime, while you set that up, some more shout-outs, you know. I think we shouted out everybody in the Twitch channel. We appreciate you guys. You know, shout-outs to all our peeps in the All Games family. Sean Freeman, Fred Rojas, Chip Sella, SG, and his awesome wife, Bridget B. Everybody, there's so many people at 42 level 1. We're going to plug you guys at the end, too. But we just love everybody at All Games. The people in the chat, Sub-Z, Opti, you guys know who you are. And, of course, Tim Curtis Jr., the social media maven over at All Games, and he's been plugging us as well. You know,
social media guru. I'm just gonna plug that word.
Yeah, guru's bet. Yeah.
Hashtag guru.
Yeah, but sometimes guru, you know what I hate? Like, I hate when I go to someone's like personal portfolio site and they call themselves a guru. Like, guru, I feel like something someone has to dub you. Like, it's kind of douchey if you call yourself a guru. You know what I mean? I don't know. But anyway, everyone in the chat, you guys are awesome, and we got so many good things to talk about already. Like, the first few minutes, we already had a lot of stuff to talk about because of stuff going on in the chat. And, you know, everybody that's downloading and listening to our podcast, you guys are awesome. And those numbers definitely help us keep doing what we love. We got Theory joining us in the chat here, but some more quick shout-outs to more Twitch streamers. Poopy Butts, I love that name. Shenanigans, Obizianki, we mentioned already, at Dwarji. There's a lot of awesome streamers out there. You guys know who you are. We love you. Twitch community, represent. What's up, Theory?
What's going on, man? Even though that's my other nick.
Well, do you want to be called Theory, Fraction, or Goose? Because I call you Goose, because we go way back.
Yeah. Goose is cool, though.
Goose.
But yeah, I mean, you know, Fraction's the gaming name, dude.
Yeah, Goose is my... I don't breathe hard. Your face breathes hard. Stop trolling me in the chat.
Oh, no. I'm going to warn you. Especially with that cigarette thing.
I try to keep it away from the mic. I get excited. I get so passionate about this stuff. But yeah, just so you guys know, man. Goose is going to troll me hardcore because we have a history. We used to work together in IT. Ugh, the war story.
Work together, play together.
Yeah. The play was the best.
Me killing everybody.
Goose is my heterosexual life partner.
Whoa. Feature. All right. Google. Saving or destroying Twitch? What are you thinking, Yogi? Start it out.
So, you know, we've had the opportunity to ask Twitch streamers and viewers what they think about the inevitable Google acquisition. And it's been, you know, a long time in the making. So we have a few thoughts we want to go through. But I think before we get into the points that we kind of plotted out here, we should probably address some of the stuff that was mentioned in the Twitch chat before we lose those thoughts. I think it was Gripfo to ask about how we feel about the acquisition in general. I believe his question was, and Obi, you correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe he asked if we feel that it's going to be... Okay, there we go. Do you believe that Google can benefit Twitch streamers? And that's a loaded question. The short answer is yes. The long answer is it depends. Because I think YouTube is so saturated, and yeah, anyone can post content on there. But since there's so much noise, the little people have a hard time, even if they join a network, you know, to really build their own brand and get their own audience, their own slice of the pie. With Twitch, you don't have that much of a problem with that. It's still going to be a grind, but not anywhere as near as what you see with YouTube. Now, YouTube may have 30 times as much content and resources, you know, if you look at it from, you know, the hard numbers. But Twitch is still a ground-level opportunity. It's a more level playing field. So I'm scared, I'm worried about what Google acquiring Twitch will mean to people that don't have 10 or hundreds of thousands of viewers and concurrent, you know, audience following at any given time. Mm-hmm. What do you guys think?
Well, I don't... Theory, go ahead, Theory. I'm gonna think about what I want to say.
I know, and we, you know, if we sounded at all mean-spirited at any point in this. Just realize we're just passionate, and this is what we do as a
living.
We're
not assholes. We're passionate.
Yeah, I mean, this is part of our what's the word I'm looking for here? This is what brings the bread and butter for us for the most part. Well, there's other things we do, but this is a big part of what we are and we do as a living, not just a hobby for us. So it hits home for us. I think one of the things I would say, that there's a lot of people that are writing about, and again, if you want a little backdrop for this whole discussion, like, I'm getting so excited my glasses are fogging up. But you know,
you go, guys, he is breathing hard. That sounds real nice now. Are you the paper boy?
Oh, man. It always goes back there.
Get your ass back here.
Pervy Herbert. But, yeah, you know, the article we have over at geekyanswers.net will give you some more background in it, and more from a gamer's perspective. Like, everybody that's written about this so far is hitting it from a business perspective, and they're all like, this is great. It's going to be the best. It's going to be an explosive synergy. It's going to be a synergy nuke, a synergy explosion, and synergy, you know, circle jerk. Wow. And all this. So the word synergy's dropped so much. Yes, but they don't realize that what makes Twitch special is the fact that it caters to the pro circuit and the casual gamers alike. That's huge. It's not just about the big names, you know. That's what YouTube's for. It's like people that have the dreams of being famous one day, they go ride the coattails of the big personalities and say, one day I'll work for Machinima, one day I'll work for IGN. But on Twitch, people are living the dream, and they're doing their thing, whether it's big on a big scale or a little scale. It's still significant. Well,
Even with, in what I'll answer the question now. Really, I really think Google can help Twitch, but on the other end, it's kind of, I'm kind of mixed up in between it, because really, if you're a new person starting out and you join a network, okay, nine times out of ten, you're not going to get to do anything with your own shit because you have to be on that network, okay. There's a couple of networks out there that actually let you play on your own, you know, run your own Twitch stream. They have streams for you, so you can if you want to, but you're not getting any benefit if you get big. You know, if people watch you, 500 people watch you on the network, well, guess what? That's getting paid to the network. You know, you're getting a fraction of what you could get if you just did it by yourself. Mm-hmm. So it could help, but then with Google, if Google takes over Twitch, I really want to be careful because I don't want to stick my foot in my mouth. But if Google takes over Twitch, it's going to give people a lot more area to basically like advertise it. Yes, you can advertise on your Facebook and all that other stuff. But if Google integrates something with when you go live on Twitch, your Google Plus just, you know, sends out a thing to all your friends, or just does this or does that. But you can set it up with just Twitch too. So I mean, like I said, there's evil on both sides, and I don't know which one to pick. So it's kind of like it can help, but it can really ruin somebody.
Well, if you think about it from like let's think about it from like an IT position. Mm-hmm. You got Google. You got their network infrastructure. Let's say they do keep, they keep YouTube and Twitch separate completely. I mean, there's a lot of room for improvement, you know, as far as like their networking and stuff like that. And I think they would probably improve on it. Even if they kept everything separate, that would probably be the best way to keep everything, you know, running the way it is, you know. But I mean that's just me. I mean, I've seen Google take things over where I always brag to Yogi that I love the phone that I have right now because it's the Google Nexus, and they're good at what they do. And on one hand, Yogi's right as well, because sometimes they'll pick something up and they'll abandon it. But I don't think they'll abandon Twitch if that is the case, that they end up buying it.
I don't think they're going to abandon it. I think they're going to totally integrate Twitch into Google.
Don't do that.
Yes, I know, but I'm saying don't do that. But I think that's what they're going to do. If they're going to buy it, they're not going to shut Twitch down. I'm sorry.
Oh yeah,
that's not going to work. They're not going to do it. because then they'd be losing thousands in revenue every day. Millions.
Oh, yeah.
So you know, the they would integrate it with Google if they do anything, is what I'm saying. I hope they buy it and they just leave it the fuck alone.
Yeah.
But they're not going to.
I think the happy medium, if they want to put their Google germs on it, you know, spread their seed onto it, is that they should just integrate on an opt-in basis some of the Google tools. Obviously, their server capacity and their resources, we want that. We want that improvement in the performance. No more server disconnection, no more connection drops, you know, that weird stuff. No weird artifacting because the server can't keep up with your bit rate. None of that stuff. You'll be the only person that'll be the bottleneck is the broadcaster themselves. That's great. And we'll have better tools and all that stuff. But to just take Twitch and insert it in YouTube, it'd be such a clusterfuck. Because what's going to end up happening, this content that is perfect on Twitch, that would not make sense in the YouTube ecosystem. It will just clutter it up. But on Twitch, it's excellent. And it has that visibility, and it fits. You know, right. I think it should be kept separate. And then keep it the way it is, where when you have a quality video, a highlight that you want to share, you can selectively put it up to YouTube. That's the way it should be, and I think they need to see that from a business perspective. It makes sense, because that's what makes Twitch special. And it's not just the fact that people could play copyrighted music and kind of break some rules with DMCA and all that stuff on Twitch. That's part of it, but the big part is the warmth and the tightly knit nature of the community. So mm-hmm. if you can have the best of both worlds, have the muscle of Google and the technology know-how that they have, without the cumbersome aspects, like integrating Google Plus with the YouTube channel. You ever try that? Or you ever try breaking up that relationship? Pain in the ass.
Yeah, they delete your shit.
Yeah, if you're not careful. Yeah, if you're not careful. We almost had that happen on the Geeky Antics channel after we uploaded a bunch of stuff. So, you know.
But I don't think they would do that, though. I agree with Obi. And I also agree with Yogi. If they leave the platforms completely separate, you're gonna see an improvement on Twitch. Maybe if they do little small changes and things like that to put their quote unquote brand all over it.
Their seed.
But no.
Yeah, it's their seed, right? It's like you said, if they keep everything separate, like as I've lost train of thought, so I'm going to try to wing it. If they keep everything separate, like you said, everything I think will be fine. And then they can give people the option to integrate with Google or Google Plus, or to not just integrate, but to give them little things like it's easier to link your stream, you know, because it automatically does it when you go live. You can link it that way, or you can do little things like Google started out with YouTube. Okay, yeah, but when you fall into the trap, you can't disconnect them anymore. I just left mine connected because I don't do nothing in it anyway. But still, it's the whole thing of people are. It's the same thing, and I'm gonna regret saying this, but it's the same thing the government's doing with Obamacare.
Oh,
trying to
let's not go there.
trying to basically corral everybody into one spot. Control. That's what people want. That's what big businesses want, is control over things that people are happy about. That's what people want. Because if people are happy about it and I control it, guess what? I control everything. And that's streamers. True. That's the Google. How many advances has Google made in the last 5 years? Look where they're at compared to where they started. Huge advances. Yeah. So if they can acquire YouTube, which they already have, if they can acquire Twitch, which they're probably going to, if they can acquire all these social medias, hell, I wouldn't even be surprised if Google wouldn't even went after Twitter. I'm telling you, I'm not. It won't happen. Twitter's too big for that already. But still, it's the point of, are they going to destroy it? Stan said it in chat a few minutes ago. Everything that Google purchases, they devastate it. They just trash it and throw it off to the side. If it doesn't work, it's awesome, but they'll run it into the ground until it doesn't work anymore. And then we'll have to have something new. we'll have to have another streaming channel or another streaming network because Google just totally destroyed Twitch.
Yeah, Google treats their acquisitions like they like a lot of Americans treat foreign cars. They just run them to the ground, and then when they realize the repairs are too expensive, they're like, "Oh well, let's just leave it on the side of the highway."
Yeah.
But here's the thing too. Like a lot of the journalists, they're just monkeys in suits. They have no connection to the gaming industry. Other than the fact that that's what they write about or they see the monetary interest in it. Because the gaming industry is becoming, it's already bigger than the movie industry, let's be honest. So all these monkeys in suits are like, oh, esports, we got to get ahead of that curve, you know. So Google's like, okay, so, you know, if we get this, we could compete with MLG, we could do this, we could do that. Because they tried to do it themselves and it didn't work. But I don't think that's what they should do. I think they can have that esports portion, but they need to also have the casual gaming and the niche segments of Twitch as they are right now. Because not just about esports, there's plenty of people doing that. And a lot of people are going in-house with their esports coverage. So that's not something that's very viable or sustainable. It's not ripe for the taking. And I think MLG is going to kind of shoot themselves in the feet like they have already. So, you know, they don't have to really compete in that space. I think the opportunities will arise naturally. They need to keep what's there now and build upon it. It's really simple. Cause look at the Twitch Partners program now. You talked about this, Obi. The way the Twitch Partners program is now is if you're friendly and you send them an email and try to appeal to them and say, hey, I have these websites. I've established this brand for this long. You know, I do these shows on podcast format. I do this stuff. You know, and I have this stuff that I'm doing that I think I could grow my channel. They'll give you a chance. They'll give you that sub button, or they'll at least give you a featured placement in the games that you do, or at least give you the ability to control the ads the way you want to.
But the one thing they don't tell you when they do this to you, they say, we're going to give you a chance. But if you don't succeed, if you don't meet the criteria that we can, you have to have this many, and it's like triple of what it was before. 50 or 60 people regularly, you stream 4 or 5 times, you have the followers, you have this, and this. And if something happens and, you know, something happens and you can't do a show for a week or if you lose some followers or whatever like that and they gank it, you actually have to work harder to get it back than you would if you'd have just waited a little bit, grew a solid following, and went from there. I mean, yes, they will give you a chance, but if you don't succeed, you're screwed.
They've actually gotten a lot better with that. And again, it's very subjective. If you develop the relationship with them, they're willing to give you a chance. I know a lot of people that have gotten the sub buttons and they've fallen off. Maybe they take a break for 2 weeks, which in Twitch time is a long time. A month in Twitch time and not streaming, that's a huge amount of time. That's like taking a year off from work. Mm-hmm. They give you a lot of elbow room. Yeah, exactly. You know, who does that? Like, imagine your boss. You tell your boss, I'm going to take the next couple of weeks off. Excuse me? No.
Hey, why don't you just stay there after that because you don't work here anymore.
Yeah, exactly. But right now, the way it is, it gives people a chance and there's more flexibility. They'll work with you. Mm-hmm. With Google taking over, if Google takes full control over everything rather than letting them run as their own division, it's going to be scary. Now, there is some encouraging stuff. From everything I've read and everything I've heard from PR contacts, it seems like Twitch themselves, Their ideal scenario is to have a partnership with Google, where they'll be part of the Google brand, but they'll still be able to do their own thing. And the main reason they're doing this is because they realize they can no longer keep up with the growth and sustain it. They need some outside funding. And venture capital is messy, so why not just team up with someone that already has the infrastructure to help them do what they want to do? So if that is true, and that, you know, the folks at Twitch are honest about their intentions, that's great. I just hope they don't renege on it and say, hey, we got our money, let's bounce and go on to the next thing. Can I be sad?
It would.
What do you think over there, Goose? I hear you laughing.
No, I'm not laughing.
He's probably watching the stream and see that we're both sucking on one of these fucking electronic cigarettes, and so he's probably laughing at that.
Yeah, we're being hipsters right now.
I honestly think what the best would be for everybody is for Google to bring them under their wing. Problem is, it's like how you and Obi are saying, if they're gonna, you know, modify it and, you know, just run it into the floor, then that's gonna be a sucky part. But I mean, if there's enough people that are voicing their opinion saying, hey, we like it this way, we like it that way, you know, they're not, I don't think, because they end up losing more money than
millions.
I mean, especially with the amount of how many users you got on Twitch, it's not like a service like where it's like, I'm not gonna say Facebook or anything like that, but what was that other one that they used to have?
MySpace?
Black Planet and...
Oh, Mi Gente?
No, the other one. You know what I'm talking about. Yes.
Mi Gente, yeah.
It's not something like that.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, it's interesting you mentioned Facebook, because Twitch has already surpassed Amazon and Facebook as far as peak usage. Because you know how Facebook, they love throwing out they like padding their numbers, and they'll say, we have the most users in our database than any other platform. Yes, they do, but a lot of them are shell accounts or abandoned accounts or, you know, alternate accounts.
Yeah.
But
or dupes.
Twitch, what's that?
I said, if not, more than likely, they're duplicates, you know.
Yep.
Oh, shit, I have just 3 Facebooks alone just for, I mean, what I do. I mean, mm-hmm. I have my Obi-Wan X2, I have my personal one, I have, you know, something. Well, I had another one, but even just 2. I mean, just 2 accounts for one person. And you know, how many people are on Facebook?
Ugh, yeah, it's a disgusting number, but...
Like 17 million or some shit, or billion or some shit like that?
Yeah, it's
crazy. I mean, there's an enormous amount of Facebook people that just like it, and then Twitch has already surpassed that, so I can kind of tell you, because at any given point, all right, and if you look at the Twitch, all right, at the top you see League of Legends always. Now, every now and then when Dota 2 is running a tournament or something like that, they'll be on top. League of Legends, there's never less than 1,000 live channels in there. That's 1,000 people right there. Mm-hmm. You got Hearthstone, which is the next one. You got about 800 to 1,200 channels in Hearthstone. Okay? There's 2,000 people right there just in 2 games. That's daily. Streaming. They might not have a bunch of people in their streams, but there's 1,000, like League of Legends, like I said, 1,000 people. The top person has 28,000 to 30,000, which is one of the TSM guys, more than likely. And then you have the other ones that are down. If there's a Riot, a Riot series on, a League of Legends, you know, a whatever it's... Yeah. Anyway, if there's one of those, you got 100 to 300,000 people watching that game. I mean, there's just... Yeah. I'm talking double.
There's an obscene amount that are watching, you know, League of Legends. Yeah, no, I definitely get that.
But the important thing here is that Twitch has a metric. Twitch is focusing on metrics that actually matter. The main one is peak usage. That means how many people are actually concurrent, how many users are concurrently on, what's the average amount of viewership per channel. Those are the kind of things they're looking at, which they're beating the pants off of most other platforms.
And it's don't get me wrong, it's not just the channels that are live on in the specific game. It's the amount of people that are in, you know, each channel too. Like I said, the top one in League of Legends is always, I'm telling, 9 times out of 10 it's a TSM player if they're streaming, and they have 20 to 30,000 people in just watching them. It's crazy. You know. I mean, it is crazy. I mean, there's just so many things that you can do if you just put yourself out there. I mean, really, I mean, I don't know if I want to say that, but
what was interesting too is
Yogi
that
puts himself out there.
I knew it was coming, but
yes, he does.
But you know, bastard. But you know, YouTube has.
Are you taking my spot, you bitch?
Derail, go. Sorry,
but you know. YouTube has bigger numbers in certain areas, but people don't spend long periods of time on YouTube like they do on Twitch. Twitch almost becomes kind of like a lifestyle for a lot of people. You know, you don't do it in short bursts, like watch a video, then close out of YouTube or put it in the background or whatever. And YouTube admits this. This is an opportunity. So they had to make this. They have to make this move. They've had to make it for a while because Twitch does things that they don't do right now. And that's why they need to kind of keep it the way it is. But, you know, what people are worried about is what's going to happen with the copyrighted material. You know, do you have to walk on eggshells like you do on YouTube? Like, you know, are there certain games that are whitelisted, certain games that are blacklisted? It's going to be such a logistics nightmare for people because you're going to have to go out and contact the companies and get permission to stream the things and or make videos and all this stuff. No one wants to go through that kind of stuff. It's such a barrier to entry. And really, these companies should see as free marketing because they're hiring PR people to do the same thing, to create viral campaigns. Twitch does that for you naturally. Just allow people to have that freedom. So, you know, I think we're going to start seeing, if Google doesn't do this right, is we're going to see people doing a lot more indie games and trying to do a lot more niche kind of marketing to stay on the safe side.
And finding a different streaming platform.
That's the other thing.
Yeah.
Because
I'm telling you right now, I don't give a damn. I'm not going to stay on Twitch if they're going to just totally fuck it up. Excuse my language. I know I've said 3 times today, but I'm not going to stay here. I will find another. I mean, we just won't be live. I mean, we'll just record the damn show. I'm not going to deal with it. I'm not going to, because really, same thing they did with YouTube. When YouTube came, damn it, it's my bad. When YouTube came around and says, hey, we got to stop all that content. All right, the gamers, what did the gamers say? All right, then we'll just play different games. If Twitch is going to do the same thing, the gamers are going to say the same damn thing. All right, we'll just play different games, and we're going to make you lose millions of dollars because we're going to move to a different platform, a different streaming platform, or a different, just a stream. Mm-hmm. I don't know what it would be called.
I mean, there's already some alternatives out there, but I have no doubt in my mind that if Google botches up Twitch, someone else will make a platform just like it. Why not? And who wouldn't want to join something on the ground level?
It's going to happen. Everybody's going to want to join at ground level. Problem is, same thing's going to happen. They're going to grow so fast that they need bigger, a powerhouse behind them, and the same thing's going to happen to that one too, because the big powerhouse is going to say, okay, we're going to back you, but you're not allowed to do this anymore, this anymore, this anymore, this anymore. So guess what? The gamers are constantly getting screwed.
Yeah, but see, Twitch was started on the ground level. Maybe what they could do is just initially make it so that people that are already, it looks like to me, people that are established on YouTube already, but people that already have established personalities, maybe they have Facebook or Twitter that has a lot of activity. Because even some of the popular streamers on Twitch, when you look at their Twitter, they have like 100 followers. It's like, how does that happen? You know? But you know, if they look at those kind of things and say, all right, because you got to look for people that have consistently built something over time. Mm-hmm. And then that's the way you could gate the quality, because you want people that are going to actually do something with a channel and not just be casual about it, at least initially, because you don't want people just clogging up the network with garbage content. You know, and that's how you could gate it, but still make it accessible enough and inviting enough. So people could do it. So Google does have to tread carefully, because I think people could come in and make something, build a better Twitch. Because even Twitch itself, even though it's in a class of its own, Twitch still has a lot of severe opportunities, and it's because they don't have the resources. So hopefully Google handles it the right way.
I just want to say, though, if they do handle it the right way, and I hope they do, because this is the reason why. For the streamers that make videos, okay, that make videos constantly, and I'm going to just name a few, Trick2G, you know, a lot of the pro players, they do little videos, and you know, I think Civ HD does a bunch. But for those people, if Google does this right, since they already have possession of YouTube, the one thing that could be benefited that I can see from acquiring Twitch as well, and this is that they leave it alone, is it will be easier to stream, edit, and upload to YouTube right now.
Oh yeah.
So if that can be done, because you got to realize how many people are streaming that have just a badass game and they just rocked it and they want to just throw up a couple of highlights really fast or even a video on YouTube.
Yeah.
So where all they have to do is have an internal editor, Okay, it might cost Google a little bit of money, but they got the fucking money. Add an internal editor, okay, that everybody can use. It's not a hard or nothing like that. If they want to do sound, you know, effects and After Effects and all that shit afterwards, they can pull it and use Adobe program
video
or
editor.
You know, a video editor. Sorry, yeah, thanks. But just to make that easy, to where all they have to do is just throw in their intro, throw in their outro, be able to type on there, do a little cut and copy or a little editing on the video, and immediately, right after it happens, within 5 minutes, they have a video on YouTube as well. That will be I can't wait for that.
Yeah.
Because
that would be great.
Like right now, we could sit here and as we're doing the show, I'm already prepping for as soon as we're done with the show, we put it right onto YouTube. For you know, like what would you do with your uncut stuff? You know, yeah, you run it through a volume mixer and stuff and all that. But for post production, I mean, it'd be so much easier just to get that to where I could play these games. Oh my god, that was a badass game! I'm gonna put that on YouTube right now and just do a couple clicks and it's there or it's uploading or just whatever.
Yep. There's one more thing. Go ahead, Goose.
Sure, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, I mean, you look at Sony with the PS4, and I know Yogi don't like the PS4. Xbox guy.
Well, actually, before you speak about that, it's funny because I think Microsoft and Sony both made offers, but Switch actually said they didn't want to do that because they didn't want it to be an exclusive thing. So that's an interesting kind of thing to keep in your back pocket. All right, so what do you think?
Well, no, I mean, no, right now, I can do the same thing on Twitch. Right now, I can edit it. I can't make any fancy graphics or an intro and an outro. But let's say I'm playing a game on PS4. Boom, I can record it. Boom, I can upload it either to Twitch or I can stream to Twitch with the PlayStation 4. And there's an actual app that you download, you install, and you can do your little edits if you want to do a montage or, you know, however you want to handle it. Xbox is a little bit different. I believe from Xbox One, and don't quote me on it because I haven't used it yet, but I believe you can upload directly to YouTube, but I didn't see if there was an editor or anything. When I'm playing my games, I just want to play, to be honest with you.
Yeah, they just do it through the OneDrive and handle it that way.
Yeah, exactly.
It's similar, just a slightly different model. But yeah, they should have that kind of stuff native to Twitch, though, you know? That's what it should be, like, out of the box.
Well, no. Well, the PlayStation does that. It has it native. Like literally, you can edit it. And then from there you hit, I don't have the controller in front of me, but you hit what would be the select button in my head, and then a little menu pops up, you upload, and boom.
Right, but why don't they have that on the website? Like, the Twitch website should be like your central hub, where you go in there and you want to do certain things, manage your channel and all that stuff, edit your video. That's what I'll be saying, is if they make it all a one-stop shop within the Twitch ecosystem, that'd be the ideal. I mean, don't you agree?
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's what has really happened. I want to speak to one more thing before we move on, because we're talking about a Twitch partners program, and Obi brought up a good point about how they sometimes they'll give you a chance, and if you don't meet certain criteria, they might just say up the ante and say, "Oh, you really gotta work on these metrics before we can consider you for these kind of features," because it takes a lot of administration for them to make you a partner. There's effort involved in that. It's not just a flip of a switch. And they're putting their brand on the line as well. So there's kind of a lot of consideration there. But I think one of the things that's interesting is that if Google embraces that tightly knit community, that almost indie spirit that they have with Twitch, because it started as a Kickstarter project and the community voted with their wallets. Right? If they keep that spirit alive, maybe what they could do is make it easier for people to get that subscriber button or become a featured channel within certain niches just based on personality and your existing track record in social media or something else that they could see. They could look at it kind of like if you were a hiring manager, all right, you don't have experience in this industry, but you have the transferable skills, you have the personality, you're a fit for what we're looking for. And if they can change that model up like that, it'll be a benefit to them, because what happens is some people won't put in the effort because they tell their friends, hey, support my channel, or they tell their family, support my channel, but then they go there and they look at it and it's like, oh, okay, it doesn't look special. It looks like, to them, in people's minds, it's a hobby. But once they see that subscriber button, once they see it's the featured channel, they're like, oh, this is kind of a big deal. This person has their own exclusive thing carved out in this network. And then people take it seriously. So it puts the broadcasters and the consumers into a mindset where it's like, all right, this is kind of a big deal. Let me actually throw my support behind it. So sometimes I think you kind of got to put the carriage before the horse, or the horse before the carriage, rather. You know, or however the euphemism. But, you know, I think there's something to be said about that. I know. Sometimes my brain works in Spanish, and I'm thinking in Spanish, and then I would say retarded things. Obi knows. And I'm like, mira que pasa aquí. Oh, no, sorry. It's wrong show.
Uh-huh. So what we do want to ask you guys is, what do you guys think? Will this improve or ruin Twitch is the question. We guys want you guys to give us feedback. And if it will ruin it, for whom? Is it going to ruin it for Twitch? Is it going to ruin it for Google? Is it going to hurt Google in the end? But you guys can join us at geekyx.net to discuss the topic. And or you can leave us a voicemail or fax. Voicemail is 206-415-4987. And of course, if you're shy, you can email us at mail@geekyantics.net, I think. I have to scroll up and look at it.
That is correct. You got it. You nailed it.
So you guys can give us some feedback, but we do have, we're just going to keep rolling right or wrong here, Rogi. We do have a second feature, right? I think it's more of a quickie feature.
We'll treat it as a quickie because I know you're dying to do it.
No. I don't have to. Now, the second feature, and this is something for if somebody else wants to join the call, you guys can. We're going to talk about, this is Hearthstone. Nope. League of Legends. Wow. The cardinal sin of law, or LOL, revisited. Okay. Yogi, what is the cardinal sin of League of Legends?
So yeah, remember in the beginning when we used to talk a lot about League of Legends? We had a segment we did a couple of times, the cardinal sins of League of Legends. So we're revisiting that. Just to kind of get people thinking more about League of Legends from a deeper perspective. Because I had an interesting chat with Derek H. over at All Games. And he's the main guy over there besides Scott Rubin. And we had a debate. We're playing Risk online on Pogo. And I think I have the video up on Geeky Antics, so I will get it up there. But on YouTube, by the way. But he was like, oh, that's an action game. League of Legends is an action game. I'm like, no, it's a strategy game. That's why it's an art. Action, real-time, strategy. But people treat it, and I noticed this so much, people treat League of Legends as a purely action game. It's like the Call of Duty of MOBAs. People look at the kill-death ratio, and that's all they think about. Like, I haven't got enough kills. Oh, I've died too much. And that's all they think about. Like, seriously, there's more to the game. The strategy layers are so deep. They're undeniable. So then people joke around, it's like, yeah, there's strategy in League of Legends. Do I go top, middle, or bottom? No. There's more than that. Stop it.
No. And I'm going to add this. I'm going to add this to this right here. And you can write it down as I'm adding. But when you're in League of Legends, the strategy part comes from whenever you want to do something or move anywhere in the map, you want to start 2 minutes prior to when you want to do that. If you're going to get a dragon, okay, and the dragon comes up at 10:06 and it's 9 or it's 8:06. Well, we know we have 2 minutes on that dragon. All right, let's start getting some wards around it. Let's do some clearing, you know, supports and jungle. Clear the wards around the dragon pit. We're going to place our own wards. So at that 2 minute mark, you know, at the 1 minute mark, everybody goes back. Everybody goes and buys and gets as much gear as they possibly can get. And then at that 2 minute mark, everybody is around the dragon. Four to set that up, even though they set this play up, this one play, they set it up two and a half minutes ago. Because everybody knows the buffs are 5 minutes, the dragon's six, and the Baron is seven. Is it seven or eight for Baron? think it's 7 minutes.
Yeah, something like that. I haven't jungled in a while.
So it's. I mean, you know, you guys will see if you, once you guys start playing with, you know, more league with myself and Yogi, you'll see when I'm gonna call out something. I'll say, okay, guys, let's start getting the dragon ready, or hey, it's 24 minutes. Let's start leaning towards the Baron, or hey, it's 20 minute mark. Let's start leaning towards the Baron. Let's get that thing. You know, even if we don't get it early, let's get it now because they're three died and we're pushed up in mid. Of course, we just took the bottom tower and Hib on the enemy side. Let's go get Baron. It's the furthest away from Baron. That's what you want to do. You want to strategize on how you're going to play and how you're going to beat the hell out of somebody. Yes, it's action. 90% of what the game is action, but if you don't strategize, you are going to lose. That's just how it is.
I'm with you. I thought you had another thought. So yeah, the timing is a huge thing, and I think that's more of a mid-range to top-tier consideration. I think there's fundamentals that people are missing. The basics. Like, you know, one build does not fit everybody. Like, people say, oh, you should go to Mobile Fire or Team Solo Mid or all these other sites to learn the builds. That's great to give you a baseline, but, you know, there's recommended items to help you with that, and you'll get a feel for what works best for what class. You know, builds should be not just based on your role and what character you have, but you have to think about the counters, you know, counter build. And I say this all the time, I sound like a broken record, but it's so huge because I hate when the thing that happened in League of Legends that makes it, part of it what makes it so toxic, is that people spend more time looking at someone's freaking ranked play, their ranking, that's redundant, I know. But they look at their ranking, and they look at their item builds, and then they immediately assume, oh, you're a noob, you know?
You're just a bronze player.
Yeah, exactly. And so it's like, dude, focus on your play. I got this. Like me, I don't have that many normal wins, but I've been playing since the beginning of League of Legends when it was in beta, and it looked terrible. It was a terrible game when it first came out. It looked worse than Minecraft. Dude, League of Legends, when it first came out, right, Goose? Remember when it first came out? The graphics were worse than Minecraft, and that's saying something. It was like Fisher-Price, my first video game. It was terrible. It did not attract you.
I remember.
Right, and you saying that, Yogi, with, you know, worry about your own game, and you just wrote this down, but if you're worrying about your own game, why are you blaming the jungle for not ganking in time? Dude,
Oh, shut up. That's another one.
If you're worrying about the jungle not ganking, why are you playing so aggressive? Okay? Did I just spank your ass because you were waiting on the jungle and you just couldn't 1v1 me? Or in the bot lane 2v2 me? If you're worried about what your support's doing and what your you know, if you're bot lane, I kind of have to put this out because I play ADC. It's not my main, but I mean that's my second. I mid or ADC, but If I have a support, I'm going to be saying, all right, put a ward there, and there, if I know what I'm doing. If the support's putting his ward there, okay, he misses a ward or he misses a sweeper. I'm not going to sit there and yell at him just because he fucked up or he didn't take the death and he got me killed. Hey, it's part of the life. Hey, man, you're the support. That's what you're there for. You're there to take the hit. If you die, that's on you. You know, you got to play and move yourself around, get yourself in a spot or a position so where you won't die. Don't be on one side of the enemy and your team is on the other side, so the enemy all they do is just come and chase you. Play smart for one.
Yep. And Stan Farina's joking in the chat. What's up, Goose?
No, I was gonna say, see, I'm horrible. Like Yogi knows how I do.
You're not on my team.
Oh man, I remember when I first started. It was who did I used to play with? Was it Ash?
Yeah, that's kind of what everybody kind of starts off with her.
Worst ADC in the world.
Aw, she still has a place. See the problem.
Hey, come play Ash, and I'll play my ADC. All right.
No, I'm gonna let's finish. Let Goose finish the thought. But I'm gonna say the problem with the ADC role is that it always comes down to like 3 to 5 picks, and then everyone else considers the rest garbage. They're viable, but it's going to be harder to play. But go ahead, Goose.
Well, no, I'm just saying, like, it goes back to what Obi was saying. A lot of people don't play their position. I mean, I got better with Ashe, but I couldn't just stay with Ashe.
I started moving on to a couple. I don't remember the names anymore, but Teemo was my main one. And I remember I was playing against another Teemo on the other side, and you were, and I think it was, you know who it was? It was Spathy. He kept on telling me, he was like, Goose, just put mushrooms everywhere. Just put everywhere. They're not rushing mid. Just everything. Cover everything. And it was like, everywhere they walked in mid, they couldn't get past mid. It was just like, boom, 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 all the mushrooms. And that's all I did. I don't remember what the outcome of that game, but it was hilarious.
Yeah, with Teemo.
Yeah, no, it goes back to, if you're overextending yourself and you're gonna yell at the guy that's jungle, I mean it's dumb. You're gonna overextend yourself. You're gonna get caught out there, especially if you're not, you know, I don't want to say pro, but if you're not on their level and they're just, you know, taunting you to come out, yeah, sure, come on out. They're gonna gank you.
It's usually pretty obvious when they try to bait you. But, you know, one of the things I love about Teemo, like, Teemo gets crapped on so much, but he's still one of the most versatile champions out there. But what's interesting about him is that most people, they put their mushrooms in very obvious places. Dude, do you remember, you know how I am with Claymores. Ever since Ghost Recon, Rainbow Six, I put Claymores in the most jacked up places, but I always catch people, they're like, who puts a Claymore there? That's exactly the point. I'm not going to put in the bottlenecks where you're going to expect for it to go, but I'm going to try to guess where you'll end up moving, and then I'm going to put in the most, this not obvious place, so you'll jump in, fall into it, and not know to ward or look for it there. It's great. That's what I love about Teemo. Is you just catch people off guard, and then they die. It's like, no! It's great.
Nah, but I remember you used to put it, like, around the corner. As you're going around the corner chasing somebody, you're like, boop, 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 run away. And then it's just like, poof. I remember a couple of times playing against you.
I piss people off. They hate it. But hey. But, you know, about like, overextending. That, and Stan Farina was joking around in the chat. It's like, yeah, the basics. Knowing how to land an attack. Well, more importantly, even people that know how to attack, they don't know how to position themselves. And this is the problem. They always externalize the opportunities. So they blame their team. So, of course, they're not going to improve because it's always the team's fault. It's the jungler's fault. It's the support's fault. That's usually what happens. Or the ADC's fault because they didn't get enough CS. They didn't get enough farm, enough creep kills. And, you know, and the thing about it is even people that know what they're doing, they don't position themselves well, or they're either too aggressive or too passive. And you got to know when to switch the gears, because the overextending thing is huge. You push your lane too far, and you're making yourself ripe for a gank, and you're making it hard for the jungle or whoever's floating around to be able to come and help you out, because now you're so close to the tower and so far away from support, you're behind enemy lines. You're making it harder for your team, so you're decreasing your chance for success. But this happens all the time at all levels of competition, and it makes my brain explode, you know. Or you get the guy. You know, it's not, as well as the positioning. You gotta always stay in motion, because if you're not, you like you see the top tier players, the players that really play well and get consistent good results. They're always moving around, and all you hear is clicking all the time, or they're holding down the mouse button because they never stay still. You know, and it's like a mad clicking fest. But it's important because if you don't do that, when you do go in for a kill or you do try to do something, you telegraph what you're gonna do. So you gotta kind of stay.
Yeah.
You gotta bob and weave, you know, like Muhammad Ali up in this. You know, this is so many subtleties to the game, but people try to just dumb it down and make it like a Call of Duty thing where it's all about kill death, and that's your value. How many kills you had, and how little deaths you had, and there's so much more to the game that I think would help people appreciate the nuances and the subtleties of the game, like, you know. How valuable someone is when they give you an assist, or they ward and prevent what could have been a catastrophe. You know, vision wars, people have this mindset that only support and maybe jungle should be warding, but everyone should ward. If you have, especially if you're getting good farm and you're ahead because you got a few kills, buy some wards, help your team out. Why the hell wouldn't you? It helps your entire team, it protects you. And you could, you know, when you got things under control, you could tell your team, hey, And I noticed that this guy just went through the jungle there. Man, be careful. There's probably a gank coming. You know, and you could come in and help out. You could be ahead of it instead of reacting all the time. I mean, wards. Why don't more people ward? But no, the support has to be warding and just constantly buying. Like, how is that fun if the support is relegated to just buying wards and placing wards down all over the place? Like, who wants to do that? That doesn't sound like fun.
Yeah, basically.
That's like.
I was gonna say that's like
it's like creating a game where your job is to paint drywall. This is your job. Drywall painting.
Here's your brush.
Here's your brush, and you can choose what paint you get, but that's all you do. You paint all day, and then you have to watch it dry. That doesn't sound.
Do you remember that old video? I don't know if it was you or Spathy that linked it when we were talking on Skype that day. But I remember a guy who just is just straight wards all over the place. It's just crazy. Like, that dude was serious, man. Yeah. I remember that game specifically because you're like, oh, look at this dude. And he basically warded almost all the way up to the front of top lane on the opposite teams. But it was crazy. And all he was doing was jungling.
Yep.
But the ganks were amazing in that video, man.
Yep.
And that's just by himself. You know, I was just like, wow, this guy is really good.
Yeah. There's such a huge gap between the good League of Legends player and an amazing League of Legends player because they pay attention to those little details. Like, let me ward this area because they might try to set up a rape bush here. Or they might try to steal our buffs in our jungle. I mean, yeah, the rape bush. How many times did that catch people?
The like, rape bush. Butt rape bush.
Is that the tri bush?
Say that.
The tri bush or the bush in the river. Or the one that's by on the way to...
Baron or Dragon?
To Baron. I was going to say Roshan. I'm thinking Dota.
Well... I put a pink ward in that little bush right in front of a dragon pit, just like the one over by Baron. I put a pink ward and it stayed there the whole game. Nobody walked through it. Are you serious? So we could see you every time. So like, oh, hey guys, look at that. They're getting dragon. Let's go get it. Okay, let's go get it. We just snatch it from them and they're like, how do they see us? And they check everything and they still did not clear a pink ward. 32 minutes in is when they cleared my pink ward.
And the pink ward is not stealth.
It's visible.
It's visible. Oh, that's terrible. That kind of stuff happens all the time. But
that
you know,
we're
gonna come back to the League of Legends talk. I think we got like 25 minutes or so, and we're gonna keep the conversation going. But just you know, be aware that you do have a team, and it's a team effort. You lose as a team, you win as a team. You might have someone that's struggling. And if they're struggling that bad, you have two options. You help them out, or you say, hey, okay, well, after this, how about we go into a custom match or a bot match so you can get up to the level where you can actually play in pubs if they're really that bad. But typically, it's lack of communication. It's lack of communication, or it's just people, you know, externalizing the opportunities. Everybody themselves had the opportunity. Like, one of my issues sometimes is... I sometimes allow myself to be bullied in a lane, so I play passively and I miss farm, so I fall a little bit behind. But it's something that's something everybody could always work on. But the alternative to that is you're super aggressive and you're dying all the time. So at least I don't die a lot. If I see someone's being aggressive, I'm like, all right, you go ahead, get your farm, but I'm gonna get you. You're gonna slip up and I'm gonna get you, and I usually do. But you do have to be careful of that, just because someone hits you a couple of times. You know, don't miss out on farm. Try to get those last hits on the creeps because that gold does add up over time. And again, players are looking at the leaderboard and then looking at your stats more than their own. They're like, hey, we're 5 minutes in and you only have two creep kills? Excuse you. What's going on? Well, they keep ganking my lane, so I'm kind of getting bullied here. Well, you should be able to take on 2v1. You should be able to do that. You should be able to take off two people. What's wrong with you, freaking noob? Unrealistic expectations.
I remember a couple of those games.
Oh yeah, dude. That's like every other game. We should play. You gonna be
Man,
around?
Listen, Well, Teemo has three hands. You could take care of this. You got this.
See, Teemo's one of those characters, though, that he's so sneaky, he could get away with it. Because he's got the mobility, and then he's got the blind that makes people miss attacks. And he'll come up with that those BS kills where it's like someone think they have it. Oh, we got this, Teemo. There's no way he's getting out of this. And he'll be like, ha, 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 got you, bitch. Right, Obi?
Oh, man.
Obi was one of those the typical league players that thinks Teemo is a joke. No love for Teemo.
Oh. Teemo's dangerous.
Yeah, not if you know how to play against him, though. You can get freaking just a magic resist. I mean, yeah, he's got his Q, but I mean, you get a cloak. You can, yeah, play Teemo. You play Teemo, Yogi. Play that, Teemo. And I will 1v1 top you, bro.
You know what?
And I will smash your ass.
You know what? We're going to have a league. Guys, you're hearing it right now in the air. Whoever can stay up late enough with us, crazy mofo, we're going to have a League of Legends game after this.
For those that are just joining the show, okay, we do want to make sure that you guys in chat do know this, okay? Yogi has accepted a challenge by yours truly, and we're calling it... The horseplay battles, okay? Horseplay Team Obi right here. Horseplay Team Yogi over there somewhere. But we do want you guys on our team. I do have a couple spots open. Yogi just heard about it tonight, so he needs a whole team.
Yeah, I like how you stole some of my peeps.
I didn't steal anybody of yours. I invited them, and they chose, a.k.a. Spath.
Mm-hmm. That's all right. I got
you. Sorry, Spath. I had to throw you in front of the bus.
Wait. We talk about Spathyzilla?
Yeah.
Is he in the channel?
He's on my team.
No, he's not in the channel now because he's been actually going to bed on time. I mean, he's... You know, 5 hours ahead of us, so that's where
he's gonna hear about this shit tomorrow. He's gonna be like, "God damn, yo, Obi, what the hell? Threw me under the bus."
No, he's gonna come on. He's gonna be like, "Yo." He's the one who came up with the whole using Teemo when me and Yogi were playing back a while back now.
Season two. I'm gonna just wanna throw this on you. Theory. Season two. I played 472 games of Teemo, so I like Teemo. Okay, don't let Yogi lie to you and say I'm one of those hardcore gamers that don't play Teemo or don't like Teemo. I love Teemo, because when people say don't,
you're always taking pot shots at him. You're taking pot shots at him all the time, and
it hurts me.
It hurts my heart. It hurts my heart.
I don't give a damn.
It hurts me deep.
That's what she said.
But you know what? What's funny though, even though they changed him so that now his abilities don't scale off of AD, it's purely AP.
Just the mushrooms. They don't give any AD anymore. Just the mushrooms.
Really?
No.
Just the mushrooms got nerfed. I don't care what you say, Yogi. Dude. Just the mushrooms.
It doesn't matter though, because you know what? I still build him hybrid.
That was a package deal there.
No, well, you don't. I know what you're gonna say, Yogi. Give me a second. I want to put one more point in here because he's looking at me now, guys. If you guys aren't watching the live show, he's looking at me like, dude, I'm about to come over there and punch you in the face. Yeah. If he could punch me in the face through the camera, Yogi would have done it a long time ago. I'd have two black eyes right now. But what I'm saying is what I know what you're saying, Yogi. He doesn't scale off AD. So in the effect that when you had with your masteries that you would put, I don't know what they're exactly called. You go right down the middle and you do, you know, the AP ones and you do the AD ones. They're all like basically they're the same except for like, you know, I'm going to pull it up for a second because I know what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Every now and then. All right, you. Mm-hmm.
I played him this week, and they've changed him a lot.
Yeah, I'm talking like nerfs. The only thing that they nerfed was the mushroom. Yes, they downscaled everything from the AD side because they don't. He's an AP champion.
I've never played them as pure HP. I mean, it's funny when someone runs into a mushroom and they die from it, but that makes them a one-trick pony. I like making... I've had a fed Teemo that's hybrid or more AD than anything else, and people are like, oh, yeah, all you have is your mushrooms, and I have vision, and I can see them, so now you got nothing, and they'll come in on me, and I literally took out an entire team by myself as Teemo. Once I get fed, the hybrid or AD Teemo snowball is so freaking hard. Oh, and it's great, because then if you finally get in a situation where it's sticky, W, peace, see you later.
Mm-hmm. Well, the fuck was that? Providing...
Your mama.
That you don't get, like, when you're gonna... My mama? Okay, that was original. But, like... When you go in down into mental force and arcane mastery in the tree, why are people still putting the equivalent points into brute force, martial mastery? I mean, just those. This is all 4 points. You're still putting 4 points into the AD side. Why are you still doing that then?
I'm just saying a lot of people don't see the value in AD. Proficiency for Teemo. A lot of people I talk to, they're like, oh, AP all the way. That's the only way to play Teemo.
No, okay. Fuck that, man.
Okay, there. Let's see what happens when you get in the team battle and you can't do mushrooms. What, you're going to drop a mushroom on someone's head and run away? That's useful.
No, that's just coming from knowing the champion, man. I mean, yes, are you going to want to get a Hextech Gunblade, one of your first pieces? I would. I do. If I'm top lane by myself, of course. Why aren't you gonna get one? I mean, you're getting your I can't even freaking think right. Because your Hextech's got your AD and your AP.
Yeah.
So really the only thing that's, everything's been nerfed to the point where a Hextech is not gonna be very good on Teemo anymore. Why do you need that extra attack damage? You know what I'm saying? It's of course I do too, because the more, basically with attack damage and you got a hybrid Teemo, you're getting a fuck ton of attack speed. So if he puts down his Q on somebody, he can attack 6 times before he has to run away. Guess what? And that's 6 times, that son of a bitch is dead.
And it gives you sustain. Yeah. I mean, if you get fed enough, you get that Triforce, and you go in there like, you know, Link in the Zelda games and hold it up above your head, you know, a little Triforce, be like, da 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 da, you know what I'm saying?
Now, here's the question for you. Would you start and rush Triforce on Teemo? Why or why not?
It depends how the farm is going and the situation. Okay,
but it's you and Ryze. Okay, you're ahead on farm, but it's Ryze. Would you go blitz and get your Trinity Force?
With him, I might try to get to bilge water as soon as possible, because then I could slow him down and get out of a sticky situation.
Hextech?
Yeah, so probably the Hextech first with him.
And what? All right. Now, for you, Theory, I'm going to ask you this question because Teemo's your dog. In what instance, what champion that you're facing in top lane, if you know, would you get your Triforce first?
Oof, it's been a while since I've played, I'll be honest with you.
Yogi knows. Because that's who he played against.
It's been a while, so I don't even remember half of the equipment anymore. Yeah. So I wouldn't be able to answer you.
Yogi?
I mean, you know, top lane, we're still seeing a lot of Renekton. We're still seeing a lot of... I've been seeing a lot of Pantheon. Who else have been seeing top? I still see some Darius. So, I mean, it really depends. You get some people that do some bold stuff in there. But I like the Triforce because you get the extra mana. You get the buff from your attack.
As right? What number item?
As what number item?
Mm-hmm.
Number 3, number 4 maybe. Because, I mean, you could build it up.
You're going to push it down to 4?
It depends, I mean.
Well... Because if you're gonna play, and this is the way that you just said that you're gonna build Teemo, 9 times out of 10 you're gonna rush that bilge water, right?
Yeah.
To get that slow to aid you in killing, right? So basically, what you're gonna rush eventually is your Hextech.
Yeah.
Right.
So sometimes, all right. So sometimes what I might do, so to answer your question, Obi, I might get the bilge water and then decide I'm getting a lot of extra farm, and then I'll start building the Triforce. After getting boots, of course, because you want to make the first or second item, right?
Why would you... Okay. Go ahead.
Well, both of them together are amazing. So I might get the... With the Triforce, you can start off with the AP track and build the... Help me out here. What's the AP sheen. Item in there? The sheen, sheen. Right? The sheen... Mm-hmm. Or I might go with the attack speed item, or I might go with the phage, right? Mm-hmm. So it really depends. I guess it depends against the matchup. Because if it's someone that's susceptible to AD, I'm going to go heavier on the AD track. But if someone is susceptible to AP, I might go a little heavier on the AP and keep poking at them with my Q and whatnot. You know what I'm saying? So this, I don't have a one-size-fits-all right. approach to it.
Okay. That's understandable. What I would do, and this is just me, because I've played so many games just like you have, just like both of you had, I've played so many games with Teemo. Get your Hextech, get your Bilge Water Quest, because that's just going to be your main item. Yes, why are we talking about Teemo anyway? And then why would you not?
Why not? Team why Teemo, Team not, Teemo in the chat.
Team Teemo, that's okay. Anyway, why would you not go Leandre's? Opposed to Triforce, it's going to take you another 20 minutes just to build the Triforce.
Yeah, but you're building it. It's little items that build up to something bigger. And you're getting immediate value from it. Leandre's, you don't get the full value on it until you build the full thing. I mean, you get the mask, but you don't get the same amount of sustain.
Like if I go to AD why would you go all the way and build a Triforce, which is... Somebody help me and tell me if I'm wrong. Why would you sit there and build a Triforce when a Triforce is 3,800, I think, or 4,200 gold, and you could just build a Leandre's for half that and have just as much sustain and then start building your Triforce number 3 or your Wit's End for attack speed?
How much is the base item for Leandre's? I love Leandre's, don't get me wrong, but then you're going back to focusing more on AP and the poison. Sometimes you want to be able to get a little more burst.
Yeah, but you don't want to be full AD. You don't want to have that full AD right up front. Because this is and hear me. You might hear me out, Yogi. You might want that full AD up front. But for somebody like me that it plays a little bit more aggressive than I should sometimes, I'm going to want that ability power. So I kind of, you know, prank them into saying I'm going AP, and then all of a sudden I build a I got my hex tech, which is going to be a little AD. You're going to then build your Leandre's to give you sustain. And then you're going to build, of course, you're getting your boots in between. You're either going to build your Wit's End or your Trinity Force. Mm-hmm. Now, then it's up to you on where you're at in the game. If you're freaking, 20 CS ahead of, say, just Renekton. If you're 20 CS ahead of Renekton and he's barely got his freaking, barely got a Giant's Belt, definitely just nuke the hell out of him, rush your Triforce and just do nothing, just beat his ass all game long until you can't do anything. But if there's no point in it, he's not building magic resist as a Renekton or even a top laner. They're not building magic resist, they're squishy as fuck against magic.
Yeah, and you could poke him, let the poison do the work, poke him, let the poison do the work. But again, in a face-to-face thing, I like to sustain with the AD track. So again, it depends. It also depends on my moves. Sometimes I'm like, okay, I feel like trolling you with mushroom than going heavy on the AP. So, but we'll keep the conversation going because that's one of the main.
I threw us off topic. Sorry.
Yeah, we did. Because we were.
We had 25 minutes. Now we got 10.
No, the team Teemo love, and this team Teemo love in the chat too. There's so much you can talk about him with that. I think we have to do legalize after this, but are we gonna do? Yeah, I think definitely. Are we gonna do deals for Cheap Bastard this week? I don't really have anything. Do you have anything?
No, we don't have any. It's the same stuff, guys. You guys want to go check out some really cheap games? We'll give you a couple of links real quick.
Yeah.
Cheapshark.com, SlickDeals.net, Bandonia.
Abandonia.
Abandonia.com, CoolROM.com, and Vestal. I saw that. VestalGames.net. You guys can go check out. They're really cheap. If you guys like to play video games, but you don't have a lot of money like myself and the Yogi here, we're cheap bastards just like you guys. Go check those out. While we don't condone piracy, there are plenty of games, of course, that you completely free due to the do the developers or the the licensing do their kindness. So you guys can of course do that as well. But of course, Horseplay and Geeky Antics, we don't condone piracy just because it's bullshit. You know, they do the spend the time to make the game for you. At least buy the damn thing.
Tim Curtis in the chat says, he wrote something, he said, pretend this is in all caps, Trials Frontier has music nearly identical to Hearthstone. Lots of exclamation points in parentheses. That's great. He knows we have a lot of love for Hearthstone here. We try to keep the Hearthstone talk minimal today, but we're going to come back to it. It's inevitable. Yo, got like, 10 days left on this season? Now 9. Right now. People listening on all games or listening on downloading on a podcast provider of their choice, you might have less time. It might be too late already. So,
right,
get on that.
Well, for those that, and I'll do this later, man. Well, my wife wants people to start adding her on Hearthstone, but she doesn't want to give her name out. So I add me, and I'll send you a name to. She beats my ass. She beat me 4 games in a row with different characters today, and I got so pissed off, I shut the game off.
Obi, by the way, one thing that to give you a heads up, I don't know if you noticed it, but with the last, maybe a couple patches back, people could find your friends through you and Adam. Mm-hmm. So, like, I didn't know your wife's name, but I just did, I put the first letter in, and then it came up, I'm like, ha, I'm adding her. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of creepy that people could do that. You could, like, add people.
It makes it easier, though. I mean, a lot easier.
It does.
Gameplay and stuff like that, so.
And people ultimately can say no. They don't have to add you. They get the request and they can say, I don't know who you are. Click, Yeah. I've gotten a bunch of people adding us, and I don't know if they're listeners or what, but half the time I don't recognize them, but I add them anyway. I'm like, whatever.
Definitely. Go ahead, yo. You're doing something right now.
So we got 7 minutes left, so we can freeball a little bit before we go into our plugs and whatnot. And for you, Obi, I trimmed down the plugs a little bit. I'm going to trim them down even more.
Thank you. You guys have no idea. I read the plugs every week and trying to get everything going for so we can get off the show. And there's a mile of freaking plugs that I got to plug. And we don't even use half of them anymore. So.
Because we spread the love. We spread the love, man. And we give credit where it's due. But, Goose, before we start wrapping this up, you have anything you wanted to add to what we discussed today? The night.
Have you guys played Rust?
Rust, Don't Starve meets
yes.
Far Cry 3.
What are you talking about? Rust is great. Rust is like Minecraft, except you're naked and you have to chop trees and get iron and stuff. Meanwhile you're hanging out. That's a great game. I actually really want to buy it now.
I've gotten some experience with it, and I love the concepts on paper. Like, I love Minecraft on paper, but again, it's the kind of games that unless you have people to play with and a server that you could go into, it's kind of like a lifestyle game. You really got to have people to play with you routinely to really enjoy. Like Space Engineers, I love that game, but I haven't been playing it that much because I don't know how many people that play it.
I got about an hour in it, and that's it.
Yeah, so you probably have more than I do. I put 30 minutes in. I had no idea what I was doing, but I was having fun doing it. But it's more fun with other people. I love the concept. There's another game, Landmark, that Spathy's playing, and it's kind of a similar thing, but it's more like sandbox and build a bunch of crap. Holy crap, what? What?
Well, I mean, I was playing. I was watching the videos that they have for Rust, and it's like basically, yes. They have servers set up by other people, and then they have the servers that are set up by the actual game company. And I forget what the name of the company. I think it's I don't remember. But I mean, either ways, I mean, I think when I was watching this guy play on Twitch. This dude, he just walked up and, quite literally, somebody walked up to him and robbed him there. He was like, drop all your stuff and walk the other way. Holding him up with a gun. Naked dude, don't have nothing. He dropped everything. He walked back.
It's pretty hilarious. I mean, but I mean, I haven't seen Landmark yet. But you know me, I love, you know, anything that makes me laugh when I'm playing it, yeah. Definitely a good game.
It's those are definitely those kind of games where it's just you troll yourself sometimes.
But now we do want to keep the conversation going, of course. Let us know, and you guys can email us or voicemail us at, you guys can fax us or voicemail at 206-415-4987, or email us if you're a little bit shy, you don't want to hear your voice, mail@geekyantics.net. Did I just say that right? I did. Please keep them short, guys, because we will play them live. I know we didn't get to any today, but we will play some. I'm going to make Yogi put it in the show notes. We will play some next week. Horseplay Live is everywhere that you can podcast, guys. Please leave us some reviews and favorites. Subscribe on YouTube, on iTunes, Stitcher. Guys, it really helps us out. We really appreciate it. Every time you hit that like button or if you do on anything that we have, it does help out. You guys have no idea. Also, give us tons of thumbs up on Stitcher so we can show up in more search results as we grow, gang. And of course, you got to remember all games communities. The gang is growing, guys. We want to tell you that right now. It is growing every day. Check us out on YouTube, youtube.com/geekyantics. Yeah. Wow, that messed me up. And Twitch, guys. We are going to be starting that here in the, I don't know exactly when. We're not going to give you a set date yet, but we are going to start streaming this show on Geeky Antics pretty soon here. So we will let you guys know as soon as that happens. So you guys can come visit us over there, of course. And we're going to do some really interesting things for, you know, when we get followers and we get milestones and all that good stuff. I do want to say something really quick. It's not on here, but you guys, we do have a Facebook page. Hey, we are halfway to our goal of the first 100 likes on our Facebook page. Go check that out, guys. Facebook, Geeky Antics, and you guys can check. I saw today we have, I think, 49 likes on there. We just started a couple weeks ago. We got 49 likes. We want more, guys. We want to hit that 100 like mark. When we do hit that 100 like mark, I will have a surprise for everybody. We'll do a giveaway. Probably, maybe even on Horseplay right here, maybe even live. We never know. So, that being said, we do want to appreciate, of course, big shout-outs to our flagship show over at geekyantics.net, the Gaming Death Podcast, our newest addition, our newest podcast addition to the Geeky Antics family. They'll be on Twitch over at twitch.tv/death. Gaming Death every Thursday at 9 p.m. Eastern Time, right before our show live. So you guys go check them out. Show them some love. We are super stoked to have Chris, Dawn, Caleb, and Hollow, joining the gang. So we really appreciate that. Check out our friends at A Worthy Opponent, 42 Level 1 Gaming History 101, the B-Team Podcast, R9 Cast, Knuckleballer Radio, Pixelated Pints, which is a new show. You guys check that out. Zombie Cast, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Cast, Fantastic Forum, Sega Nerds, Castubris Doctor Who Podcast, The Angry Chicken Podcast, and the Party Chat Shows on All Games Network. Holy shit, that's a lot of people.
A lot of love to be spread. Well, a lot All of Games, love. All Games we Network, they are part of, they're part of All Games, they're part of Geeky Antics, or any place where you can find geeky goodness or get podcasts at. And let them know that we sent you over from Horseplay.
And of course, just from us here, Obi and Yogi, much love to the All Games family. We love you guys just as well. Now, we do have some ideas from upcoming episodes. If you guys do want to hear us talk about an episode or just be involved in one of the episodes that we do up, you guys can set us up with all. You leave a voicemail. Hey, I got an idea. You know, leave an email, a fax, anything you guys can do. You just hit us all up. It's right there, right in between us. You guys do see all the stuff for what I'm talking about right now, all the links, I guess, for what I'm talking about right now. But let us know. We do have some possibilities. We're going to, of course, in the future, going to be talking about League of Legends, Hearthstone, and just a whole bunch of different other stuff. And, of course, that's just our flagship. Basically, that's what we talk about every week. But just let us know what you guys think of Google's latest moves and future on Twitch. Leave us those voicemails, guys. We do want to hear, and we do want to hear from you. Theory, do you have anything you want to plug up, man, before we jump out of here?
I don't think I have anything to plug. Unless you guys want to come down to Costa Rica and get drunk, but yeah, that's about it.
We can do that.
Yeah. We got a worldwide audience. I love it.
Hell yeah. But we really appreciate you guys. If you guys are listening on allgames.com, B-Team is coming up next at 9 p.m. And it's about 2 hours from now, Eastern time. Be sure to hang out in the chat room by clicking on the live button right there in allgames.com. You guys can check us out. And, of course, give B-Team and everybody else some love. And just give them all some love. Tell them Horseplay Obi-1X2 and YogiZilla sent you. And they'll probably tell you to... that's not a very tasteful word anyway. Yogi, you got a few things that you want to shout out before we get out of here?
Well, I'm excited about the new show you got going up with DocRoe, because Netherlands, mm-hmm. Netherlands is and like Brazil are like really... I just off the top of my head, those are like sections that are booming in gaming, and there's not enough representation. So it's cool that we're going to get ahead of that, have the Netherlands represented, because let me tell you, there's a lot of people out there doing their thing over there. So it's up and coming, and we're going to be part of that with Geeky Antics and the All Games Collabo.
Right, right.
Exciting and times.
If you guys didn't hear the previous in this show, real quick before we get out of here, myself, DocRoe, we're going to be starting a news talk show on Sunday morning. Is at 9 p.m. or 9 a.m. sorry, Eastern time. It's early, but it's for EU guys. It's for you guys over in Europe, of course, with Doc living in the Netherlands. We say it so weird.
We do.
He lives in the Netherlands, so we want to make sure that he can get his voice and his name out there, of course, and... What better way to do it is right here on Geeky Antics. So this is Obi-1X2, my partner in crime right over there, YogiZilla. We'll see you guys next week.
Peace! Hashtag NL loved. Hashtag Team Teemo.
Yeah, exactly. See you guys.
Peace. Giggity, giggity, goo. I'm still recording, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
The uncut Horseplay behind the scenes. This is where we get super nasty. Balls to the wall. All action all the time. It's Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. I don't know. I'm trying to get Goose excited. I'm trying to make him giggle like a little schoolgirl.
I am not a schoolgirl.
All right, guys.
At least not on the weekends.
Yeah, right. Yogi, I want to play some Hearthstone, and then I'll get that thing loaded up to drive.
You play Hearthstone?
No, League.
Oh, I was about to say, okay. We could do that, too.
Yeah, we got about a three-minute buffer, because it's about a minute and about 2 minutes or so in the beginning of the show. So you should be fine with that. Yeah! Thanks, guys, for watching. Over at Yogi's channel. We'll see you guys next week. It's Obi-1. I'm Adi.
Peace. Word.